Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Goldman Sachs. I am really, really excited to have you all here today and super excited for us to host our first Investor Day. We're all very grateful for you taking the time to spend the day with us. As Heather just mentioned, we're going to ask you to hold your questions till the end of the day. That said, you should feel free to break into open applause anytime it suits you. Today is about our path forward. Our goal is to clearly communicate our strategic direction, our plans for execution, our financial objectives, and our paths to achieving these goals business by business. And all this comes in the spirit of communicating directly with you about the ways in which we believe we can drive greater shareholder value. So let's get started. Having just marked our 150th anniversary, we've spent a lot of time thinking about what does Goldman Sachs stand for? How do we articulate our purpose in the world? What's unique about this firm? What makes Goldman Sachs special? And this comes at a moment when I believe that all companies need to more clearly explain their purpose and their values to their employees, to their clients, to their shareholders, and to their communities. It's about having a North Star that guides your strategy and enhances your culture. So simply put, our purpose is to advance sustainable economic growth, and financial opportunity. We are proud advocates for capitalism, and we understand the extraordinary benefits that economic growth brings to all of us. We are passionate about our role in the world, and we believe this sense of purpose is motivating and inspiring our people. In addition, we believe that this focus resonates with our clients, who themselves are increasingly mission and purpose driven. So, how is GS position to deliver on this? We put capital and ideas to work to expand the potential of organizations, accelerate global economies, and amplify personal prosperity. Delivering on this purpose means marshaling all of the people and all of the resources of Goldman Sachs to serve clients more broadly, more effectively, and more efficiently. If we can do this, we have a deep conviction that we will, over time, deliver value to our shareholders. This clear sense of purpose is fed by a sense of long-term values. In 1979, John Whitehead wrote down 14 business principles which have codified our distinctive culture. These principles still inspire us today, but in the spirit of simplicity, we've distilled them down to four core values. First, partnership. This value speaks to our legacy, but most importantly, it drives the way we interact with each other, with our clients, with our investors, and with our communities today. Our partnership ethos fosters a sense of ownership and stewardship that we believe is unique and differentiated, driving collaboration, inclusivity, and teamwork, and inspiring us to put clients at the center of everything we do. This brings us to our second core value, client service. Having personally spent decades building relationships with our clients, I know how much value can be created for our clients and for the firm through exceptional long-term dedication to serving clients' needs. Let me give you just one example. As a firm, we've worked for two decades with Disney. When we asked Bob Iger for his views on working with Goldman Sachs, he said, and I quote, "While it has been highly productive from a transactional perspective, it is our connection with the people at Goldman Sachs that has produced the most value. We deeply respect and appreciate their advice, their knowledge, and their feedback." Deep and respected client relationships like these are born from our third value, integrity. I am personally laser focused on this. We must always have an unrelenting commitment to doing the right thing, always. In the wake of our experience with Malaysia, I am keenly aware of how the actions of a few can harm our reputation, our brand, and our performance as a firm. Finally, excellence. Commitment to excellence is a mindset that permeates this organization. It informs the kind of people we attract, the advice we give, the way we strive to meet our clients' expectations. Every day in this firm, I get excited as I see people going the extra mile, pushing their limits and working together just to make things better. I recently had a discussion with Marco Argenti, our new co-CIO, who joined us from Amazon Web Services. I asked Marco about his impressions at the firm. He told me he was most impressed by the level of talent at the firm and how exceptionally dedicated and hardworking the people of Goldman Sachs were. So these values, partnership, client service, integrity, excellence, are the backbone of our culture. They also, in our view, have driven some fundamental competitive advantages for the firm. Built up over 150 years, these advantages are defining, they're durable, and they're self-reinforcing. So I wanted to spend a couple of minutes touching on them now. First, we've built a global presence, allowing us to serve clients everywhere that matters to them. We stand at a point today where our international revenues have grown 22-fold since 1990 and now represent 40% of our overall firm-wide revenue. We have the right people in the right places around the globe in a model that we think is efficient and effective. We are known for quality, depth, and duration of our relationships with corporations, with institutions, with individuals. We're taking a long-term view, and we understand that great relationships require investment and patience. We've done survey research recently to better understand our clients' experience with the firm for the last 10 years. Our clients have consistently rated us as having the best people relative to our peers by a wide margin, with our most recent survey showing a 20 percentage point gap to our nearest competitor. Our research also tells us that Goldman Sachs is the number one firm our clients would recommend to peers for business. I've mentioned the exceptional talent at the firm, and I frequently hear that our people are differentiated, and I know firsthand from my own interactions how truly exceptional they are. We've created an ecosystem that attracts and develops our people, giving them platforms to thrive and grow. The group of presenters you'll hear from today illustrates this strength. These leaders will tell you about businesses that have innovated for decades, inventing new categories, new approaches, new products. Innovation has never been more important than it is today, and we are deeply focused on the mechanisms that encourage fresh and creative ideas. And you'll hear more about this from Stephanie Cohn, our Chief Strategy Officer, and Marco, who I mentioned just a few minutes ago. Our history, our people, our ideas have made Goldman Sachs an aspirational brand around the globe, a brand that has proven very influential with institutions and in corporate boardrooms. But it also translates and resonates with new and different clients, such as consumers, who are attracted to our products and services. Finally, our attention to risk management forms one of our most important and distinctive advantages. Risk management means protecting not just our capital, but our reputation as well. We leverage strong processes, deep analytics, empowered risk and control functions, and a culture of honesty and direct communication. Stephen will talk more about this, but I want to impress on all of you how personally important this capability is to me. From my perspective, the depth, interconnectedness, and durability of these advantages is unparalleled in our industry and makes us one of the most distinctive companies in the world. At the same time, this is a place that always seeks to improve. We've discussed our purpose, history, core values, some competitive advantages. I now want to talk about the changes we're making to drive Goldman Sachs forward. First, we're seeking to increase our transparency. Better transparency will improve all of your understanding of our business. It will improve visibility into our activities, and it will enhance our own accountability. Some examples of this commitment include our new segment reporting, our new approach to earnings calls, and obviously, the fact that you're all here today. We are also trying to be more open and accessible, both internally and externally. This has led to tangible changes, like modernizing our work environment, engaging more actively with the media and our communities, and encouraging people to express themselves authentically. These cultural and symbolic shifts have the effect of humanizing this organization while expanding and enhancing our brand. But perhaps most importantly, they play a meaningful role in making sure we continue to recruit and retain the very best talent. As an organization, we're also seeking to become more dynamic. To me, this means making decisions more quickly, being more flexible, and striving for progress, not always perfection. But make no mistake, we remain committed to excellence in everything that we do. But in the world that we live in, we must move faster, and we must be willing to experiment more. I also want the firm to be more long-term in its thinking. We have long prided ourselves on being nimble and reactive, and these qualities are hugely valuable. But my goal is to shift the culture a bit more in favor of institutionalizing and incentivizing long-term thinking. The investments we are making will require patience and fortitude. We are planting seeds that will take time to mature and grow. Our new 3-year planning process and the targets we will share with you today are emblematic of that commitment. We think this orientation will allow us to deliver greater value to our shareholders over time. So there are a number of things we're trying to evolve at Goldman Sachs. But from my perspective, the most significant change we've set in motion since I've assumed the seat is a major effort to reinforce our deep client orientation throughout the firm. We call this effort One Goldman Sachs. One Goldman Sachs is a firm-wide effort to simplify the way we engage with our clients and deliver all of our capabilities in a more holistic fashion. It's a huge strategic priority for us, and one you'll hear more about from each of our leaders on the stage today. In particular, John will give greater detail on our efforts in this area. Historically, we've been able to deliver our capabilities, the broad capabilities of the entire firm, to a set of big, complex clients. Let me give you one example that illustrates the power of this approach. And it's suggestive of the opportunity if we can apply this approach much more broadly across the organization. We've developed an extraordinary relationship and partnership with Apple over many years. But very interestingly, we did not participate in the Apple IPO. That was a missed deal. However, Apple turned to Goldman Sachs in the mid-1990s during a very difficult time for that organization. At the time, we led the industry's first ever overnight convertible bond deal. It was a deal that allowed Apple to invest in its future transformation. By the way, that innovation became a product that's an everyday part of the capital markets today. Over the next 25 years, we advised Apple on a number of high-profile strategic and financial transactions, on shareholder activism, on capital allocation. To put it in perspective, we helped them raise more than $125 billion of debt. We executed numerous transactions that have led to having Apple become the largest share repurchase program in history. And most importantly, today, because of the foundation of that relationship, we've been able to partner with Apple on our new credit card offering, which is a key component of growing our consumer business. So we've been able to deliver strategic advice, capital markets and securities service, investment management capabilities, and a consumer partnership, all in a fully coordinated, holistic manner. We have the opportunity to do this for so many more clients, building relationships that are characterized by depth, breadth, and consistency. So far today, we've talked about who we are, what we believe makes our firm unique, and some of the changes we're making. Now, let's discuss where we're going in the future. First, I'd like to talk about the environment we operate in today and the way we perceive the world's evolving around us. This forms the basis for our strategy and our approach to operating our business. We are living in an era of enormous change. Technology continues to advance profoundly, giving us the ability to transform existing businesses and access new profit pools with platforms that scale. Perhaps there is no group where this is more evident than with consumers. The consumer today has access to sophisticated capabilities in the palm of his or her hand. There are vast opportunities not just to extend, but also to simplify these capabilities. We think we are still in the early days of this revolution in financial services, creating a big opportunity for our firm. We have lived in an era of globalization, but today things feel a little more complex, a little more unpredictable. In this environment, more clients want to turn to Goldman Sachs for our perspective. Corporations continue to be focused on their bottom line laser-focused on their bottom line. But to drive that in the long term, they must do so sustainably and responsibly. This is leading to a change in investing strategies, governance models, and broad corporate strategy. Sustainability is a significant priority for us here at Goldman Sachs. That's why we recently announced a $750 billion financing, investing, and advisory target across 9 key growth themes for our clients, including clean energy and accessible and innovative healthcare. And you'll hear later from Greg Lemkow about our new IPO requirements for board diversity. We'll continue to be at the forefront of these changes and well-positioned to help our clients navigate in this new world. The rapidly evolving landscape creates an enormous opportunity for our firm. This environment also dictates a new approach to operating the business. And I'll briefly describe some of these changes, several of which I've already touched upon. Rapid change and global complexity make it imperative to bring all our capabilities to clients in the spirit of One Goldman Sachs. The scale and the scope of the opportunities ahead of us require us to adopt a more long-term-focused mindset, which is exemplified by our new 3-year planning process. This opportunity necessitates a commitment to investing for growth, tolerating J-curves, and staying committed to new initiatives. Finally, all these dimensions mandate that we operate more transparently with you, thereby driving much greater accountability. This new operating approach is consistent with our 3-part strategy, which is already in execution mode. The strategy is simple, clear, and has driven tremendous alignment for our leaders and for our people. This framework, I think, will be familiar to most of you. We have a powerful portfolio of existing businesses, and we see opportunity to grow and improve them all, leading to more wallet share and higher revenue. We see several opportunities to diversify our business, grow new platforms, and drive more durable revenues. And we will operate these businesses more efficiently, driving better returns for our shareholders. If this seems simple, that's the point. Simplicity allows for a clean and focused strategy. When you hear from our business leaders today, these will be consistent pillars driving their forward plans. After thoroughly reviewing our franchise, we concluded that we have an incredible foundation that clearly has room to grow. Our current businesses have leading market positions, operate from a position of strength, with products and services that they provide to our clients. We have the undisputed number one investment banking franchise. We have a leading global markets business. We have a top 10 global active asset management business with leading positions across the full spectrum of assets. We have the premier ultra high net worth wealth management business here in the United States. The aggregate is a unique ecosystem that differentiates Goldman Sachs from the firms that we compete with. We are committed to these businesses, and each has substantial room to grow. We are already executing on extending our investment banking footprint. We are optimizing our global markets business to produce higher returns and are harnessing technology that allows us to better serve our clients. We can scale our asset management business by partnering much more broadly with asset allocators. And we can grow our ultra high net worth platform in Europe and Asia. As I mentioned, we also see meaningful areas for growth in new businesses. Before describing those, I thought I would share the way we evaluate opportunities for growth at the firm today. First, new businesses must spring from an expressed client need. Second, they should capitalize on some or all of the competitive advantages I laid out to you earlier. And third, they should be adjacent to and build upon one or more of our existing businesses. From a financial perspective, we target opportunities that produce more durable revenues, are capital efficient for us, or enhance our funding mix. Applying this framework has led to 4 big opportunities: transaction banking, third-party alternatives, digital consumer banking, and high net worth wealth management. I'll touch on these briefly for a moment now, but throughout the day, John and the business leaders will describe all of these in great detail. First, transaction banking, which is aligned with our corporate franchise. With Goldman Sachs as the first customer, we have already processed more than $3 trillion of payments across 5 currencies. and we're starting to roll this offering out to our clients in the coming months. Second, our alternative asset management business. We've had a strong presence in this business for a long time, but we believe we can grow it meaningfully, allowing us to capitalize on a global secular growth theme. Third, we're building a digital consumer bank of the future, serving a new set of clients in a disruptive, modern fashion, from a technology platform that we believe we can scale very efficiently. And we've made a lot of progress in just 3 short years. And fourth, we're broadening our wealth management offering to address the entire high net worth space. This initiative is supported by our differentiated corporate relationships through ACO and our recent acquisition of United Capital. Imagine a Goldman Sachs in which one or more of these opportunities really blossoms. A transaction banking business with even a small share of a massive market, one that is larger than the entire investment banking wallet. An alternatives business which adds $100 billion of net inflows, a very modest goal relative to the aspirations of many of our peers in this business. A fully scaled digital consumer bank with a broad suite of products and services. And a wealth management platform serving clients across a much broader spectrum. Our earnings power could grow dramatically. And this organization is aligned, excited, and motivated to build these businesses. So we have a great core franchise, which can grow, a series of new business opportunities that are adjacent to our core. And when you put it all together, it puts us in a position to significantly expand our total addressable market, diversify our business mix while shifting that mix more in favor of durable businesses and creating a better platform with higher margins and an improved return profile. The opportunities for growth and efficiency that I have described to you at a high level today position us and give us confidence to share with you the following 3-year financial targets. An ROE of over 13% and an ROTE of over 14% as the new initiatives scale and become accretive to returns over the next 3 years. An efficiency ratio of approximately 60%. This target is demonstrative of our managing expenses holistically and in a more focused manner. A CET1 ratio of 13 to 13.5%, which would allow us to return capital while maintaining above the regulatory minimums. We recognize we're in a cyclical industry, so these must be viewed in the context of a normalized operating environment. Stephen will, in his presentation, provide a detailed walkthrough on these targets. Consistent with our commitment to accountability, you should expect us to update you on these targets annually. But let me be clear. We believe there is meaningful upside from here in the future. The investments we're making are long-term investments. We're building an organization that we believe is capable of generating at least mid-teens returns, and that is our clear aspiration. I've shared our plans for growth. I've laid out our targets. Now I'd like to comment for just a minute on why I'm confident in our ability as an organization to deliver. First, our people, including the importance of advancing diversity. Second, our risk management culture. And third, our historical track record of success. Let me start with people. People are our greatest asset. This has been true for the last 150 years, and we expect it to be true for the next 150 years. We have incredible success at attracting talent from campuses and laterally all the way up to partner. This is an aspirational place for young people to work. We had 85,000 applications for 2,600 campus positions this year. And the energy and appreciation for how Goldman Sachs is a great place to work extends to our alumni network, with many alumni becoming clients and referring clients to us. Our people embody our core values, and they come from a multitude of backgrounds. Our clients care about the diversity of our organization and our efforts to advance diversity, and this is a personal priority of mine. The global talent pool is evolving demographically. If we want to maintain the quality of our workforce, we need to be able to attract and retain people from all walks of life. I feel passionate about our commitment to this. As the data suggests, we're making progress, but we have more work to do. In particular, I'd like to see more diversity in the leadership positions at the top of the firm. I've been a part of the Goldman Sachs risk management culture for over 20 years. Risk management is a huge part of the DNA of this organization, apparent in everything we do, how we transact, how we interact, how we manage our business. I want to emphasize, we are risk managers. We have people and processes in place to effectively navigate the risks we face as an organization, integrated with our forward strategy. Later today, you'll hear from three senior leaders, Brian Lee, Sarah Smith, and Shira Fredman, whose average tenure at the firm is over 20 years, all key risk managers at Goldman Sachs. We recognize that our risk profile is shifting as we enter and pursue new businesses. For example, the growth of our consumer or financing businesses requires us to evolve and develop our already strong credit risk management culture. And of course, cyber, geopolitical risks are constantly emerging and shifting, and we need to stay very focused on all of these. Importantly, when things do go wrong, and invariably they will, we are focused on learning, reflection, and self-improvement. To me, this is the essence of a great risk management culture. So I've spent the morning describing a number of changes we want to make at Goldman Sachs and illustrating a number of new growth opportunities ahead of us. One of the reasons I have such confidence in our path forward is that the firm has a long tradition of transformation and growth. We have a long track record of entering new markets, building new businesses, and creating world-class franchises. You'll hear more about some great examples of this throughout the day. So the quality of our team, the depth of our culture, our track record of innovation give me great confidence in our ability to deliver on the three strategic pillars I showed you earlier. And across each of these three pillars, we have a set of goals, of milestones that we want to share with you. These items will be drawn out over the course of the day as John, Stephen, and the rest of our business leaders share their more granular execution plans with you. So let me close by telling you how excited I am about the future of Goldman Sachs. Today you will see and hear a management team that shares this fundamental optimism and is committed to an ambitious, long-term vision of what Goldman Sachs can become. Thank you again for being with us today. I will see you all later when I return to the stage for Q&A. Enjoy the day. Thank you very much.